Hey, I wanted to record a new beginner's guide to starting a podcast in 2022. And I'm going to go over the equipment you'll need, a really basic setup that doesn't cost a lot of money. And then I'll show you the software you can use, as well as how to host your podcast, how to distribute it, how to get analytics, and then a little section on promoting your show. So to start off, you're going to need a microphone and then a computer or a tablet. You can also use your mobile phone. You can plug a microphone right into this, but most folks find a computer plus microphone or microphone plus tablet is the best setup for them. There are two affordable microphones I highly recommend. One is the Samson Q2U. It's a dynamic USB microphone, and it runs for around $69 US. The other one is the ATR2100X. It's very similar to the Samson, and if you can find either of those at your local audio store, on Amazon, Walmart, I would start with that microphone. You should also purchase one of these, a pop filter. These can be around $10. And you place it right in front of the microphone. And what we're trying to eliminate is what are called plosives, which are those harsh mouth noises like Peter Piper went to get a pizza. The way to eliminate that is to put your pop filter about a fist length away from your microphone and to speak about this far away. You don't have to be right up against the pop filter. You can go back. And this is kind of the ideal setup to make sure that you sound as good as possible and you don't have to do as much editing later on. Once you have your microphone, there's a variety of software you can use to record your podcast. My go-to recommendation for the Mac is GarageBand. It comes free, pre-installed on every Mac. It's also on your iPad and your iPhone. And to get started, you just click empty project, just choose your input and click create. And then it's going to give you a track for recording your show. So generally the first thing I do in GarageBand, unclick that count in and metronome, and then just head over here, click record. Hey everybody, it's Justin Jackson and I hope you'll join me for my new podcast. I'm launching it here in 2022. We're gonna cover everything audio related. You can subscribe wherever you listen, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and more. Perfect. So from here, I will export that. I go up to share, click export song to disk. I don't know why they don't say audio file, but click song. And I'll just call this my trailer episode. You can choose medium quality, should be fine for most podcasts, and choose MP3. MP3 is still the universal file format for podcast listening apps. All right, so we've got that exported. I want to show you my new preferred way of recording and editing, and that is in Descript. Descript is for PC and Mac, and let me show you how it works. I'm going to click new project here, trailer episode. Now, the cool thing about Descript is it's kind of like a word processor and an audio editor combined into one. Let me show you how it works. I'm going to click audio recording here. You can see I've got a little waveform. Watch what happens when I hit record. Hey everybody, it is Justin Jackson and I'm launching a brand new podcast for 2022. You can subscribe to get more information on audio, recording, editing. It's going to be a great show. I hope you will subscribe in Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you listen. So now instead of just editing down here in the waveform editor, this kind of looks like GarageBand down here, right? We can, I could move things around. I can, you know, cut things out if I wanted to, but I can also edit this like I would in a word processor. So if I didn't like, if I didn't want to have people listening in Spotify for whatever reason, I could remove that word. It automatically removes the corresponding audio. This is the fastest way I've found for recording and editing audio for podcasts. You can also add music. Just drag it over to the spot I want it to be in, right here. And I can also remove this section here. And then this right here will have the music fade out. So if I play the whole thing now, it'll sound like this. Hey everybody, it is Justin Jackson and I'm launching. Now, I probably wouldn't choose that track for the actual episode, but you get a sense of what I'm trying to do here. So yeah, Descript is awesome for recording and editing. After you've got your MP3, let me export this as well. The other thing I like about Descript is it allows you to normalize your loudness, and generally minus 16 lufs is what you want for podcasting. So I've got minus 16 there, I'm gonna export this. So now you're going to need a place to host your MP3 files, create your episodes, generate an RSS feed, and then it's that RSS feed that you submit to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, etc. So podcast hosting is kind of like it's the website where you create your episodes. You add your audio, you add your title, your artwork, and that goes out from there to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, etc. There are a few free options you can choose. There is Anchor. A lot of people just starting out use Anchor. And there's also SoundCloud, which was originally for music. It does have a podcasting option. It's a little bit harder to navigate. I think if you're really looking for a free option, Anchor's probably the way to go. If you feel like going a little bit more pro, I recommend Transistor.fm. Most people upgrade to us for better customer support, better analytics, the ability to host multiple podcasts from one account, and other features like dynamic audio insertion, customizable podcast website, etc. So I'm going to create a new show here on Transistor. Click Add a Show, and I can import an existing podcast, but in this case, it's a brand new podcast, and we'll call this Audio Experience 2022, and I'll give it a description. So the name of your podcast matters. This is the brand that you're going to be sharing with the world, and your description is kind of like the elevator pitch for your show. The next most important thing is your podcast artwork. And the best way I found to generate podcast artwork is to use Canva. They have lots of free templates available, but you can just look up podcast and they'll have lots of different artwork available for podcasts. Over and over and over again, they've got all sorts of great pre-made templates. And so let me use this one here. We'll call this Audio Experience. There we go. Might simplify this one. I'm just gonna resize this here. And even though PNG is better quality, there's a file size restriction with podcast artwork. So download the JPEG. And now I'm going to upload my artwork here in Transistor. There we go, Audio Experience. Now I need to choose a category. I'll call this one Arts, Performing Arts. This is where it will be displayed in Apple Podcasts. And then I'll choose a secondary category. I'll put my name as the author. You can also put your company name if you're creating it for a company. I'm gonna choose the language, my publishing time zone. Again, put the show owner. This is gonna be like the administrative contact for the podcast. And then the owner email is important because that's how the platforms like Spotify and Apple are going to verify that you are indeed the owner of the show. I'm gonna click Create Show. There we go. Now we have the baseline structure for the podcast. The next thing is we need to add an episode. And some people try to wait. They try to wait to have their official launch before they submit it to Apple and Spotify. I think you should record a trailer episode just like I did now, and add that first and submit your podcast right away. So I'm gonna call this episode What to Expect from This Podcast. And I'm going to upload that short trailer episode that we recorded before. So I'm gonna upload this one here. I'm going to give a brief summary. So this is a podcast for people in the audio industry. And then in Transistor, I'm going to mark this as a trailer episode. This will give this episode special placement in apps like Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and Google Podcasts. This is kind of the episode people will get to see first. And it really is like the commercial, the trailer, in the same way you have a trailer for a movie. It's to entice people to listen to the show. So you want to make it nice and short and compelling. Record something that really puts your best foot forward, that makes people want to hear more of what you have to say. And then down here, I'm going to add some longer show notes. And I can choose to schedule this episode, or I can publish it right away. I'm going to publish it right away. All right. So on Transistor, as soon as you publish it, it's already available on the web. You could share this link here with your friends on your website, on Twitter. It's playable right now. Hey, everybody. It is Justin Jackson. And this is a great way to start building anticipation for your show. Don't hold back. Get that trailer episode out as soon as you can. But the other nice thing is that once we have this trailer episode published, we can now submit it to all the different apps, all the different places. Transistor makes this really easy. You click distribution. Right at the top, you have your RSS feed, but we also have one-click submissions for Spotify, Google Podcasts, and a bunch of other places. So I'm just going to click submit my show to Spotify. There we go. Let's go ahead and submit it to Google Podcasts. Let's submit it to Amazon. Look how easy this is. You just click a button, it automatically gets submitted, and we can also submit your podcast to these search directories. All right. Now, how do you submit to Apple Podcasts? Apple does not have a one-click submission. It's a little bit more manual. So start the process. We outline all the things you need to do here. I'm going to show you right now how to submit your podcast to Apple Podcasts in 2022. Because this has changed. So we're gonna head over here. You are going to need an Apple ID. If you are submitting a podcast on behalf of a company, I recommend you create a new Apple ID. Don't use your personal one. So log in to Podcast Connect. It's gonna ask you to verify. Once you've verified your Apple ID, you will get logged into Podcast Connect. If you've already submitted shows to Apple Podcasts, you will see your other podcasts listed here. We are submitting a brand new podcast, so we're going to click this little purple icon here with the plus sign, and then it asks you if you want a new channel or a new show. You want a new show. Now it's going to ask you if you are adding a show with an RSS feed. This is like 99% of podcasts have an RSS feed. An RSS feed allows you to submit your podcast to all of the places instead of just hosting it on Apple. So we're going to say add a show with an RSS feed. Now we're going to go back to Transistor. We're going to grab our RSS feed, head back here, paste it in, and we're going to click add. Now, this is where a lot of people think, oh, I've submitted it at this point. You know, this screen looks like we've submitted the feed, but we actually have to wait. Apple's processing the show details, check back later, and then click publish. So you actually haven't submitted it to Apple yet. And we've seen tons of customers get stuck here. They leave this window. They think that they've now submitted it. You know, they might go and check out the show on Spotify. They go do other things with their podcasts, not realizing that they have not yet submitted. So we're gonna head back here. Let's click refresh. And now all of a sudden, once I hit refresh, it's ready for us to submit it for review. This purple button is the important part. Submit for review. Then it takes Apple about 5 to 8 days for them to approve, manually approve these. They might show some errors here. In this case, we have to say we do not contain any third-party content. Save. Submit for review. Well, now we have to choose the frequency. Let's say this is going to be a weekly show. Save. Submit for review. Okay. So now our podcast is being reviewed by Apple. We can head back, and here on Transistor, it'll say that your podcast is pending approval on Apple. Now, while we wait for Apple and Google and some of these other places, we can see the show is already live on some of the platforms. Podcast Addict, already ready to go. Some of the search engines like Listen Notes, show is live there as well. By the way, you only have to do this submission process once. From now on, when I publish a new episode, it will automatically show up on all of the platforms that I've submitted to. So the submission process just happens once. If I publish a second episode, everybody on Podcast Addict will get it. That's automatic. It's just this first hurdle you have to cross. So real-time update, Apple Podcast just approved my submission. Sometimes it takes days, and in this case, it just took an hour. And I know they've been trying to improve on this. So here we go. The podcast, about an hour after submitting it to the Apple Podcast directory here in 2022, it is now live in Apple Podcasts. So a bit quicker than 5 to 8 days. Definitely make sure you go through all the steps and click that purple submit button to make sure that they see it and then approve it when they see it. Let's talk about promotion. I think when you're getting started, there's probably three places you want to start hanging out in. The first is Podyssey. This is an app for podcast fans. As you can see, people are actively recommending their favorite podcast episodes. This is a great spot for you to be to engage with other podcast fans. You can also recommend your own episodes here and at least get some people who are really passionate about podcasts to maybe take interest in your show. Another place similar to Podyssey is Podchaser. As you can see, we automatically submit to Podchaser for you here on Transistor. And again, a place where podcast fans are hanging out, recommending their favorite shows and talking about them. So a good spot to get started when you're promoting your own episodes. And also on Reddit, there's a subreddit called /rpodcasts. And this is a good place to respond to people looking for certain types of shows. So, you know, has anyone found a podcast like this one? I'm looking for an investigative journalism podcast. If that matches your show, feel free to reply with the name of your show and a link. And that's within the rules of the subreddit. Podcasting is a long game. It takes a while to build up an audience. But after you've been podcasting for a while, we'll give you analytics like these that show you listener trends, how many people are listening each month or even in the last 7 days, if you'd like. You can see all of your episodes, the most popular episodes. You can compare your most recent episode to your most popular episode and see where they differ. You can see where in the world people are listening. All sorts of ways to optimize your show here. And on Transistor, all of these stats are exportable. So if you wanted to export them as a CSV file and open them up in Excel or something, you can do that as well. So there you have it. How to record, edit, and publish a podcast in 2022. If you have more questions, head over to transistor.fm, click the live chat widget, and we'd be happy to answer your questions. You can also ask questions in the comments, and I'll try to answer those as well. Thanks.